Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to give a demo on PCPID based multi-process control trainer, in which we can study the different process controls which are following in the industries right now. And this is a basic description of plant in which we will control different types of processes, like with the feedback loops, like feedback controls, process control, cascade control, and also the ratio control method. Also, we will understand the different instrumentations like in this complete setup, like PID based controller to control the process in proportional, integral and derivative controls. Also, we will see the level transmitter working with this, also the flow process control. For this we will using wheel flow meter in this, and also there are some different types of indicators to see the process indicator, in which we will see the different values of processes working with this. So the order code for this complete setup is 52234 to 52237. You can use this order code to find out the specification and to check the what can we offer with this complete setup to study. Now I am going to giving a brief descriptions about all the parts which are included in this kit, and then we study the complete setup. Also, these parts are now using in the industrial processes also, so student can get in touch with the complete industrial process instrumentations by using and by performing the and learning with the study of this complete setup. So we start with this motor. The pump are of half HP, and these pumps are provided to supply water, which is a medium for this complete setup, and the water will be supplied to all the lines in this complete setup. Walls are used for different types of water to be flow in different sections. So we will control the wall so that water will be required as where we want to go the water. Then we have a sump tank in which the complete supply of the water will be provided firstly inside, and the sump tank should need be full to up to 80% of this complete capacity. The capacity of this sump tank is 50 to 60 liter for this complete process. Then we have wheel flow meter in this. The wheel flow meter can be give the output readings of 0 to 1000 lph liters per hour, and this is a 4 to 20 milliampere output reading of this. So when the water flow with this wheel flow meter, the output from in the current form is provided to the PID controller to control the process, to see the feedback of the flow also, and to see the actual flow of the water from this line is there is a rotameter 1. The rotameter 1 can be read flow from 0 to 1050 lph, so the higher lph is are provided, so we can see the actual flow from this rotameter, and also the electrical flow and the transmitted flow from this wheel flow meter can be observed on the indicators as well. Then we have a electropneumatic control valve. The electropneumatic control valve is the main unit to control the water flow in the complete setup. Then the electropneumatic water flow valve can be controlled with this electropneumatic regulator or positioner, we can say this. So the positioner is the basic instrument in which this have to provide the 4 to 20 milliampere supply as an input. So as the supply is provided, the output as an air will be output from the complete setup of this positioner. The 3 to 15 psi output can be provided to air through air to close the valve and to shut the valve and to open the valve. So the valve can be worked to air to close. When air is provided through this slot, the valve will be closed, and there is a spring internally connected. When air is removed, the valve will automatically upside and open the path to water flow. Then we have AFR unit in this, with the pressure gauge is also provided, so you can provide the input from the compressor line to provide the air to complete the process for air controlling of the electropneumatic valve. And there is a bypass line in which valve V3 is connected, so when we do not require the complete setup or the controlling of the electropneumatic valve, we can bypass the line by closing both the valves aside from the control valve, and we will open this valve so that water will flow bypass in the bypass line and to process the other different equipments. Then we have a level tank of the capacity from 0 to 500 mm in the height. The level tank is a transparent sheet of polypropylene make and complete square foam, and there is a level transmitter inside, which is a capacitive type level transmitter. So level will be transmitted accordingly to the water level inside the tank, and the transmitter will be transmit the level in the current form to the PID controller. To see the pressure controlling, for this we have a pressure vessel here. The pressure from the water can be provided inside the vessel, and there is a pressure gauge provided from 0 to 60 psi in the PSI range, and 0 to 4 bar approximately to see the analog pressure, which gives you the actual pressure. Also, the pressure transducer from 0 to 4 bar is also provided here, so that we can see the electrical signal transmitted by this pressure transducer on the level indicator as well, and also in the PID controller to controlling the pressure control with the flow. Also, there are temperature. For temperature, we are using a geyser of about 1.5 kilowatt in this. And the geyser is the medium to control and to increase the temperature of water, which is our medium. And there is an RTD here to check the temperature of the water from the water flowing. And the RTD will be give the output in electrical signal to the PID controller. So we can also control and feedback, check the feedback of actual temperature using electrical instrumentation. So RTD and pressure transmitter and the level transmitter are our input devices to give the feedback of the actual pressure, so that we can control and provide the supply of the flow and different types of working to see the different values. There is an MCB to control the separately of geyser, so that the high power rating device can be controlled with this safety purpose of the geyser and the different other components which are isolated from this supply. There is another rotameter and another wheel flow meter, so that when we control the flow with the flow in the ratio control, both the readings are required. So wheel flow meter will give the other flow of the line, and the rotameter for observing the actual flow of the line, and then we match both the flows. For both the flow indicators are also provided here. So flow meter 1 will be provide the indication of the flow here at this meter indicator, and the flow meter 2 will be provide the indications of the flow at this flow meter 2. Then there is a complete panel in which all the different types of selectivity and the other selections and different types of AC mains and jewel light switches are provided. PID controller 1, PID controller 2 are here provided to check the different types of controller. This is the PID input. The PID input value in the current form we can see at this PID input controller, and this is the PID 1 output controller. The output of PID 1 to threading the and controlling the process will be given, so that we can check the different types of controller. There is a bar switch, so the output in the percentage level from this bar can be checked, at which we have to perform the PID controller output. Also, the electronumatic output and PID 2 input will be given at this meter, and in cascade when we use PID 1 with the PID 2, both the input and output will be provided on this PID controller. Same here, PID 2 output is also provided. So output from the PID 2 controller in the current form will be given on this complete signals. There is toggle switch 1, toggle switch 2, toggle switch 3 and toggle switch 4, and all the position of 1 and 2 are given here. So these are required as per the practical processes. So also the complete table is given at this side of this complete setup, and as well as in the user manual also. So valve position, switch positions are required to fulfill when we do the practical of different process controls. There is also switch 1 and switch 2. These are the selector switch. So this will be controlled. At 1 we will see the pressure transmitter at this level, and then we at point 2 we will see the temperature transmitter value, and at third point we will give the level transmitter value to the PID controller. Similarly, the switch 2 is also provided to feedback to KS and to heater control card for different types of controlling. So all the switch positions and valve positions are need to fulfill to complete the process accordingly. Then we have the mains on switch, then this is a 24 volt power supply on switch, then this is the pump on switch. Pump 1 will be on with this switch, pump 2 will be on with this switch. For this we have to provide the supply for PID 1, though the switch will be on the complete supply of PID 1, then PID 2 also, the PID 1 on, process indicator 1, process indicator 2 will be on with this and process indicator 3 will be on with this. These indications are provided to indicators. All the indicators of level, process, pressure and temperature will be on when we on this indication, and flow meters are also on with this indication switch on. This is the switch at which we all the different types of indicator will be on, and the other switch is for spare purpose when we, if you want to extend the other supply and other some processes, so you can use the spare switch as well. Now to see the inside the panel, there is a complete setup and complete electrical diagram. You can use and see the different types of component which are also included in inside this. So you can open the panel by unscrew the bolt here, and after opening the panel you can see the different devices inside this. So this is the SMPS here, the SMPS to provide the 24 volt power supply to operate. So most of the instrumentation trainers are right now in the days are used on 24 volt power supply. This is a universal supply also, we can say this. Also there is a heater control card, the heater control card to control the according of the temperature controlling of the geyser as which we are using here to as a temperature device. So heater control card will perform accordingly to the output of the PID controller. Then we have a relay to on off the heater here, and these are the different converters, so that where is the requirement of converting the current to voltage or voltage to current, there are controller and converter are used. These are the different terminal blocks so that all the connections are connected with this. This is the MCB inside to power on the complete setup or devices. Also then we have the PID controller with the USB control, then we can easily communicate the complete PID controller, both the controller with the PC, so that complete setup can be monitored and observed according to the PC, and set point can be provided for different types of complete processing. Also the data logging will be provided, all the data can be observed and see the process will be controlled according to the setups. We are also offering a user manual in which all the details about the different components and different types of instrumentations component and inside the panel wiring diagram, and also the different practical informations for detailed study is also given in this user manual. You can study the user manual to check and see the different specification of the components and to see the what are the different walls and how they are working with this complete. You can use for detailed study this user manual. And in this also we are giving a sample practicals in which we will study and do the different multi-process controllers. We can do the level control, process pressure control and temperature control separately, and then we see cascade control with controlling of this. Feedback control will be also performed with this control, and ratio control will be also in this. So we will see now the practical performing with this using and following the practical procedure in the user manual. Now we are going to do the first experiment on this complete setup. For this we will study the first experiment, which is a study of feedback flow control system. In this we will control the flow using the feedback output with the wheel flow meter. Here we will provide the flow from the motor in this complete circuitry, then we provide the feedback from this complete the level flow transmitter, in which the wheel flow meter will be transmit the level actual flow, which is 0 to 1000 lph, which can be set, and we will set the set point at the PID controller to set the flow accordingly. Then the output will be checked from the PID controller, which is the actual flow. If the actual flow is more than or the less than with the set point, the output from the PID controller will be provided to control the action. The action will be controlled with this positioner. The positioner will be supply the air to the pneumatic control valve, and the valve will be open and close accordingly to the output from the PID controller. Then the level will be maintained in some of the cycles, and then we will see the how level will be controlled. Then we can also provide the external forces to change the level or the flow of the value of the actual flow, and the set point will be disturbed, and then again PID controller will see the complete feedback control loop to process the actual set point. We can change the set point also, and we can provide the external forces for this also. So we will start. Before that we have to provide the air supply to this AFI unit, and the AFI unit pressure should be set up to 2.1 kilogram per centimeter square, or you can see set the 2.1 psi to this input, because the diaphragm inside the electromagnetic control valve is very sensitive. If you provide more pressure to this, the diaphragm may damage and the false and the inaccurate reading will be provided, and the inaccurate control will be happen in this complete setup. So this is the AFI unit in which we have connected the inlet line from the compressor here. The compressor line or the 6 mm PU fitting is provided. There is some extra PU fitting and 6 mm PU tubes provided to extend your compressor line. You can ease for the process. Here you can see at the pressure gauge, the pressure reading from the needle is approximately 2. You can use the AFI unit to decrease or increase the pressure accordingly. So we need to set the pressure approximately 2.1 kilogram per centimeter square. So we'll set the pressure 2.1 here. Then we see the wheel flow meter is right now in the stop position. When we start the pump, the wheel flow meter will start rotating, and the direction of the water from this is the left to right in this section, and volts and other different values also need to fulfill accordingly to see the practical on this. The valve positions according to the experiment are also given in the sheet 1, sheet number 1 and sheet number 2 for the different such selector switches and toggle switch position are given. So as we are working with the feedback flow, which is our first experiment, so we need to set the all valve from V1 to V15 at this position. O means the open for the valve, and close means the C means the close to the closed valve, and P means the partially open valve. So we need to right now open the V1, V2, then close the V3, V4 should be open, V5, V6, V7, V8 need to close, V9 should be open, and V10, C, all other valve, rest of the valves will be in the closed position. And also the toggle switch settings are provided here. So we need to, for the first experiment feedback flow, the selector switch 1 should be at off position, selector switch 2 should be at 2 position, toggle switch 1 off, toggle switch 2 at 2 position, toggle switch 3 at 2 position, and toggle switch 4 at 1 position. Then for PID controller settings, there is feedback control, flow control setting, and these are the different settings which can be set in the PID controller 1. So we need to set and input the old setting range from 999 liter per hour in the high, and 99 or the 0 for the reading low. Then we have LPH reading in this, then PID controller in which we have to set the PD equals to 1, P equals to 0, D equals to 1, and D equals to 0, and I equals to 21, and controller action should be forward. So these are the practical readings that we have performed, and after that we have given this reading to this table. All the readings need to be set accordingly. So now we are going to turn on the trainer board, and then we set different types of readings to check the output, and then we see how the feedback flow process control can be happened through this. So first of all, we will set the valve positions according to the practical. So in this, we have to open the V1 and V2. So V1 inside this is open condition, V2 is in open condition right now, and V4 is also open. V3 is the bypass valve, so we need to close the bypass valve. So bypass valve is in the closed position right now. Then we go for V5, V6, V7 and V8. All the valves need to be closed. So V5 is closed, V7 is closed, V6 is closed, and V8 is closed. So all the valves are closed here. Then we have V9 in open condition. So V9 valve is here. So V9 valve should be open. So you need to put the V9 valve in open condition. Then we have V10. V10 should be closed. So no water will flow in the level transmitter section. And then V11, V12, V13 and V14 and V15 valve need to be closed. So V11 is closed, and rest of the valves are inside the behind the panel. So you can check all the valves in closed position, and then we see how the valve will be working. So now we are going to set the switch positions according to the table 2 or sheet number 2, in which we have to set the selector switch 1 at off position. So this is the selector switch 1, so this should be at the off position. Then we have selector switch 2 at position 2. So then we need to put this 2 at the 2 position, as we are doing the feedback control here only. Then for toggle switch 1, the toggle switch 1 should be at off position. There are 3 position. This is the 1 position, 2 position, and middle position is at the off 1. So we need to put the toggle switch 1 at the off position, toggle switch 2 at the position 2, toggle switch 3 at the position 3, and toggle switch 4 at the position 1. So all the positions of the switches are also provided. Now we will power on the complete circuit, and then we set the and put the values in the PID controller also. Now for powering on the circuit, we have to first turn on the main supply, then 24 volt power supply. Pump we do not need to control on off right now. We will on pump after setting the PID controller. So we will first on the PID controller 1. So PID controller 1 will give you some value here and also the indications. So we can see all the indications. PI 1 for the input of the PID 1 will be given here, and PI 2 which is giving the input of PID 2 and PI 3 here. Process indicator 3 will be provided here. Output of the PID 1 will be given, and output of the PID 2 is given. So PID 2 is not required right now. We can off the PID 3 for this, and PID 1, PID 2 for the input and output value, and PID controller here on the on screen. Now we will have to set the PID controller values accordingly as in given in the user manual. So we will set the value of PID controller as per the manual. For PID 1, for the feedback flow control loop, we have to set the range from range of 1000 liter per hour to, and at the low range we have to set the 0. So we'll press the set button, set PID, enter P here provided. We need to set the P equals to 0.4. so we will change the value by using these switches to 0.4. press set, then you press enter, then you go to the next value, which is I. So I need to be set 21 for this. So we change the I value to 21. 21 is the value. Press enter. Now we going to D. So D should be 0. So 0 should be placed. Press enter. Open loop 0. Open high 0. And biasing at 0. Action, we have to set this at the forward. So this is at the reverse. We press on. This is now forward. Press enter. Now to set the range, we going to range menu, press enter. So RH should be 999 liters per hour. So we will set this to 999.9 liter per hour. Enter. And low should be 0. So we have to measure the value of the liter value from 0 to 999 liter per hour. PD should be 1 as given in the user manual. Press enter. Now this is the home screen, and this is the 0 to 100% operating value of the PID controller, and this is the input to the PID right now, which is 4 milliamperes, and output from the PID is 20 milliampere. So this will work accordingly to the complete system. Now we will turn on the system and see how the level and value will be measured, and also we need to follow the user manual to see the level process control, sorry, the flow process control according to the setup. Now we will first turn on the pump 1, then see the values accordingly, what values we will getting here. So pump 1 is now started. You can see wheel flow meter flow is showing in the wheel flow meter. The flow is right now 880 liters per minute per hour. Also the flow is shown in the rotor meter is approximately 600 liters per hour. So you can increase and decrease the flow using valve 1 also. So this is the complete flow. The flow is going through the this wall, and wall is operating at this point. Now we have to enter the set point here. Set value, will first set the set values from 400 liters per hour in this PID controller. And as I set the values to 400 liters per hour, the PID control action will be working in the setup mode. So we have set the value approximately 400. This is 400, press enter, and as I press enter, the PID starts comparing the actual value with the measured value. So measured value is right now 586 liters per hour, and the set value is the 400. So PID will be working right now. So this is in the output of 100% here. Input from the PID 1 or the flow meter is 13.66, and output from the PID is 19.76. So the valve right now is in the closed position. Approximately, you can see this lid is near about the shut position here. So the flow is controlled and the flow is decreased from this electropneumatic controller. As the flow decreases, the value starts controlling accordingly. So as you can see, right now flow is 580 from the flow meter range in the PID controller is showing. So this is the actual flow, and set value or the process value is the 400 here. So we need to change or the pressure. If the in some time the pressure is not controlled or the flow is not controlled accordingly to the PID controller, check all the valves and or air supply is in proper. So here you can see the input air regulator supply is at the zero right now. So we need to provide some air inlet here so that valve starts working. Here as I giving some input, the valve is start closing accordingly. We need to set the pressure approximately 2 kgs of the air supply here. And now you can see the flow has been reached to approximately 427, which is near about the set point we have provided here. So in some time it will control the flow and reaches the set point according to the given value. So right now the valve opening is approximately more than 60%. Here you can see the valve is at the 60%. The spring you can see up down in the open and close process accordingly. Also at the rotameter we can see the flow is approximately 400 lph, and at the PID controller right now the flow is also at 400 lph near about. So in some time we will getting the feedback from the feedback controller or the flow meter, the feedback provided to the PID controller, and PID controller processing the opening of valve according to the input from the flow meter. Here you can see the output is 15 ampere to the closing position of the valve, and the input is PID from the flow meter is 10. In some time we will get accurate value. Here you can see the value is almost same in the both the set value and process value are near about. Now we can provide external forces to disbalance the flow. So we can control or close the outlet valve here so that flow will be decreased. We'll slowly close the outlet valve, or you can close the partially the V3, which is our bypass block valve. So as I close the valve, the flow will be decreased. Here at the PID controller you can see the flow is decreasing, so it will start again the process through the PID pneumatic control valve. Now we will change the set point, and we can see according to the set point the value or the process control will be seen at different set values also. Here now I have changed the set point from 400 to 500 liter per hour and press enter. Now the valve will start opening as it gets the value, because the flow is now less than the set value, so valve will start opening in gradually, and air input from the valve or the output from the PID is decreased, so output will be decreased and value will be near about the set value. So here you can see we are now reaching about the 500 liter per hour, and some of the cycles, one or two cycles, the valve will be at the stable position in some time. Here you can see input and output is almost equals, and the valve and the flow position or the flow from the pipe is approximately 500 liters per hour for this position. Similarly, you can put different types of set points and you can get the different value. The feedback flow control is a continuous process, and this will happen according to the PID controller setup. And when your practical has been completed and you get the readings approximately whatever according to the practical, and when you fill up observation table, you can turn off the pump first. So complete flow will be going to zero, and then you can turn off the other things, or you can move on to the next practical as we are going to right now. Now for next practical, in the last practical we have controlled the feedback study of the flow. Now we are going to control the feedback study of level. In this we are using the level transmitter, so level value will be transmitted through this level transmitter to the PID controller here, over here. Then PID controller will give the output to control the valve position, similarly as the what flow meter, flow feedback control, and the flow will be controlled and the level will be maintained. So we need to turn the valve position change, and switch position also need to be changed according to the table given in this user manual, and then we operate the level accordingly, and also the actual level value on the scale is also provided on the level tank here. So we will match the level from the set point, so that how much error we can get and how much controlling we can get through this system. Now for this, first we have to set the valve positions accordingly. So V10 should be open condition, so that the water flow from the this line will be provided directly to the level tank, and V9 should be closed, so the water is do not go to the sump tank. So right now we are not going to the flow, so we are going to the level. For this V10 should be in open position and V11 should be in partially open position. So partially open is therefore because we need to adjust the level, so that the level will be continuously in the outgoing from the level tank, and level should be maintained inside the level tank. Also the rest of the valves remains the same positions, just need to change these three valves. Now we will set the switch positions according to the practical. So in this feedback flow level we need to set the selector switch position in the one. Selector switch 1 should be at the 3 position. So we have set the selector switch position at the 3 position because the level transmitter input to the provide PID controller will be given through this. Now we will set the selector switch 2 at the position 2 for the feedback here, and toggle switch 1 is at the off position similarly as per the last practical, and toggle switch 2 is at the 2 position. So we have set the toggle switch 2 at the 2 position right now. And toggle switch 3 is at the off position, so we have put the toggle switch 3 at the off position, and toggle switch 4 is at the second position. So we have put the toggle switch 4 at the second position. Input from the level transmitter is 4 right now, and output from the PID controller is also at the 4 milliampere position. Now we have to set the PID controller values inside this. So PID controller value, the range should be at higher, this should be 500, and at lower this should be 0, as our tank is offering 0 to 500 mm in the range for the level. PD should be 1 and other parameters do not need to change. Similarly, for PID value, we go to PID menu. Here P value should be 0.5 as given in the user manual, and I value should be 40 and D value should be 0, as same as the last practical. Operating low should be 0% and operating high should be 100% from the PID controller. Action should be forward. And set value, we need to set the set value. So we will starting setting the point from 200. So set value, we will setting set point 200 for the starting. You can set any of the point from 0 to 500 to set the values. Now our setting has been done. Now we need to turn on the pump and see how the actions will be working accordingly. Make sure the air pressure should be approximately 2 in the FI unit, so that the air pressure supply to be provided to the electromagnetic control valve as to do the controlling or the actuating of the valve. Now we will turn on the pump 1. So now we are going to turn on the pump. As I turn on the pump, you can see the water level inside the water tank or the measuring tank is increasing, but similarly level also increasing in the PID controller. So this controller is getting the output from the transmitter, level transmitter, inside the measuring tank, and the same value is almost displayed on the PID controller as well. Now our set point has 200 value, which is 200 mm, and as the value is going apart from the and more than from the PID controller or the set value, the operating for closing the valve is now at the 100%. So valve, you can see, is almost at the shut position. So the water temperature is, sorry, the water level is almost, or water flow is zero at this time. You can adjust the V11 so that the water level will be maintained, and at there is a, when you control the actions both of incoming flow in the water tank and outgoing flow from the water tank, it should be at the saturation. There you need to control the flow will be remain constant, and the output from the level tank should be constant. At this time your level will be maintained properly. So here you can see the water outlet is going, so the water level inside the tank is going lower and lower, and output valve is now slightly open so that the water flow from the to the tank is continuously on. So we are now reaching almost near about our set point, and opening and closing of both the PID controller input and output you can also observe on the process indicators on both the sides of the PID controller. Here at the water level is almost 230 from the measuring scale, which is sticked on the measuring tank. The water level is almost now in the stable condition. You can write down the readings from PID controller reading, also the actual reading from the measuring tank. This should be has some error amount of about plus minus 10%, because some of the fluctuation due to in the water flow and the actual value, the idle case can be prompted accordingly. Here you can see the water level is now lower from the set point, so the valve will start opening in some of the instance, and then water level will starts again try to maintaining inside the water tank. So in some time or 2 or 3 cycles you will get the proper reading, and the proper controlling of the level will be happen due to this feedback control loop. Now, if we change the set point, so the disturbance to the complete process will be acquired. So we will change the set point to 200 to 300 mm for this case. Here, and some instance you will see the wall opening will be happen and water flow inside the tank will be increased, and level from actual level transmitted from the level transmitter will also increasing in this PID controller. Here you can see wall position is now in open condition, and water flow at the rotameter will also change. You can observe also the water flow meter, water flow at the rotameter. Here the level is now reaching about 300. Also at this time we will observe the actual level is now 320 inside the measuring tank, because the water level slightly increased here. So this will maintain the water level accordingly in some time. It takes some of the instance for in the start, and then input and output will be almost same, and your level will be controlled inside the measuring tank in some time. So this was the level control by feedback control. Now we are going to move to the feedback pressure control loop. In the feedback pressure control loop, similarly we have to do all the valve settings according to the sheet diagram given in the user manual, also the switch settings according to the sheet. So we first set the valves according to the sheets. In this, for feedback pressure control, we So now we are Now, Now, say Now we are Now we are Now for Here you can similar Now we move. For wall. So we'll start. Now if we now we After certificate, Here you can see now. So that